So yeah, this is very good. It's money. So then let's say that I am a beginner. So I've just finished, maybe I'm a graduate and I wanted to get into an entry-level data science or machine learning role. So I'm gonna run through kind of the learning path that I would take now, given my knowledge and my past experiences, just to give you a feel for what you might want to focus on if you're in this current position. Here, you might notice that I've put GitHub and highlighted it. To reiterate again, GitHub is very, very, very important. We do a lot of software development in our daily roles, and one very easy way to stand out as an entry-level hire would be to have very good Git skills, so version control skills. And also, if you have your own website that's run from your GitHub, that's very, very impressive. So yeah, this is very good. It's money. So then let's say I've set up my GitHub and I try and learn how to make all my commits and do different branches and all these different stuff with base level software development skills. Then I want to start learning about maybe one of R or Python, depending on what sort of role you want to get into, either the analyst role or the building type role. And definitely focus on the SQL as well. You'll see that a lot of the data that we work with lives in SQL databases. So it's very, very important to be very good at SQL. The best way to learn these two things, there are many, many ways. There's lots of free courses, books, online courses. You can learn from the documentation directly. Some of the authors of the languages also have different books that are online for free. I think in the future, I'll try and share more resources on these ones, but I don't want to pin down, you must learn Python this way because I did it. So I want to make sure that that point is very well understood. But yeah, I think these things you need as an entry level data science or machine learning practitioner. The other things that you need is also basic maths and basic stats. I know this is probably the most confronting component because people who don't come from a maths and stats background will find it very difficult to understand some of this. What I want to reiterate and highlight is, for me, the only amount of math knowledge that I needed was just enough to understand and read technical papers. So for the majority of it is just basic calculus and matrix algebra. That's pretty much all I remembered from my uni degree. And I use them maybe once a month or week, maybe, depending if I'm working on a more technical project or not. But yeah, it's really good to have those skills so you can actually read through the paper and kind of understand it at a high level, conceptual level. And then if you need to dive in deeper, there's always Google and textbooks and things that you can look into. So don't be too intimidated by the amount of math knowledge that you need. For the statistics, I just shared here that probability distributions and hypothesis testing, they're pretty much the main two things that I've had to use throughout my career of, let's say, 5 years or so in a data role. I haven't had to use too much more. There is a whole different field of, let's call it Bayesian statistics, which is very cool and new within the machine learning space. I think to move into that space, you need a much better understanding of statistics. But pretty much, you just need enough statistics knowledge to be able to design experiments and validate some of the insights that you generate. I think having the hypothesis testing, that knowledge is very important for that insight validation. And having the probability distributions gets you to think more in terms of, I think the probability distributions are very useful for machine learning specifically. You can try and think of it in, it's hard to describe for me right now. So I'll try and put more thought into it before I give you a more overall summary, but just know that probability distributions are really important. And here for the applied component, I think of these as, okay, now that you know the base knowledge, what can you demonstrate with your knowledge to apply that to demonstrate that you can use that in a real situation. And the best way to do that is to show your knowledge of common packages in the languages that you've learned. For example, in Python, you might want to know about pandas, and for the machine learning, maybe you want scikit-learn, for example. Maybe you want to do some deep learning stuff as well. And the most important thing is probably this end-to-end machine learning project. If you really want to stand out, of course you try and integrate it directly with your GitHub so you can have even more bonus points. But this end-to-end machine learning project will try to, it'll show the hiring managers that you understand where different components of the data science process fits in. And more often than not, that knowledge is more important than being able to dive into a certain, say, a certain algorithm, for example. But I think, yeah, having an example of an end-to-end machine learning project is very, very important. It would be even better if you can somehow incorporate some SQL into it, as well as the Python or the R. And even bonus points if you can also finalize whatever your machine learning thing is with some sort of dashboard or some sort of automated visualizations that you can kind of just show it in a single report. Now, so those are sort of the things that we like to see in entry-level data science. I think it might seem very intimidating because there's a lot of stuff on there, but you don't learn these things overnight. It takes time. The first thing is probably knowing what you want to learn. So I hope this kind of gives you a better picture of what we're after. Here I've put down some bonuses. So I'll just list them here without going into too much depth, but there's Docker, dashboarding. If you can write a blog or a tutorial linked in with your GitHub, that will demonstrate that you are a good communicator through written communication, which is very, very important as well. Let's see, deep learning. So I think of it as a bonus because a lot of the problems that we solve in machine learning, especially at an entry level, we don't necessarily default to deep learning straight away. I think it's much more important to understand, let's say, the decision tree, logistic regression, boosted trees, all those traditional machine learning algorithms. Having a really good understanding of them and how they play in the ecosystem and what they do, and a conceptual level of what's going on under the hood, it's much more important than actually having a lot of deep learning experience. But I think over time that might change as well, so just watch this space. I think the deep learning is becoming more and more popular, so over time I think that might eventually end up as one of the applied things, but it's more just a hunch rather than anything. And cloud computing is just a bonus, especially if you know that the target company that you're going for uses the cloud. It would be very ideal to, if you know which cloud they're using, if you can go do a Coursera course or some free course that kind of demonstrates your knowledge of what's going on in that environment, it'll definitely be a big bonus. What I'd caveat that with is that I think most of the cloud providers they're quite similar. So if, let's say, you only want to spend your time using GCP, for example, Google Cloud Platform, versus learning Amazon, AWS, just choose one of the two and just stick with it. I think it's better to have deep or good knowledge in one of them because a lot of the concepts are the same. If you try and level up at the same time, you might confuse yourself. So just try and stick with one. Hopefully that's the one that your target company wants to use, because that will look really, really good.